worse than outside teacher work before we actually even know.
I don't think anyone but you.
Pretty full day today, lots going on, meetings, session this afternoon, gym session this morning. I'm going to be based here all week. Generally when we're looking at venues, we look at what we've got in close proximity to each other. So obviously here we've got space where we can sort of chill and meet, and then critically we've got a gym on site, we've got the pitches on site, so it's got sort of everything we need all in one place.
And you can see they've got no
Some people have had a bit of a car journey, so just to get moving before we go into the gym. And then we've got a few physio markers that we need to write down, so just to see what state we come into camp and if we need to fix anything. So we've got a bit of grip strength, we've got a knee to ball, so that's like ankle flexibility, ankle range, groin squeeze. Yeah, and Luke likes to do our body weight when we come in as well.
In terms of setting the team up, we sort of set ourselves up at the start of the Six Nations knowing the teams, what we wanted to get out of our performances. And so we had a pretty good picture in mind about what we wanted to do in terms of selection. And we'll sort of stick to that, but it'll be obviously a combination of players who have got quite a bit of experience behind them and some of the younger players who've come into the squad. We're looking to give experience to players in terms of leadership on the field and also in terms of just getting some international game time. So any combination we put together, as long as they focus on performance, will give us what we want, and we just want to give them an opportunity to play and see how they go as individuals and collectively.
Focus this week for us, okay, has to be very much about us and about how we perform. I think we lost that a little bit last week against Ireland. We need to really pull back to performance, and everything we do, okay, needs to be built around that, about individual performance and about collective performance. We've got an opportunity this week to actually train how we want to train, so let's make sure we maximise it.
The one thing you know you're going to get when you play Wales is that there'll be a lot of passion, a lot of emotion around. So I think from our point of view, it's making sure that we keep calm heads and we focus on our execution.
The key is to check depending on what you're seeing and what you're feeling. Yeah. But it's don't be afraid to get yourselves together. Yeah. And then.
But I think the same for you guys as well. You guys must have been watching that, being like, we're making a load of errors or not winning from far. I like genuinely believe that you guys can help us out then as well, because there'll be times that we might be recognising it, but if we're not doing anything about it, it's not because we've decided not to. Do you know what I mean?
So sometimes you'll get the information, it's like how you use it.
Does it get deciphered as well? Does it go across the group? So let's make sure we check in on field, we check in off field in terms of what our chat is, which is generally, we'll make sure the messages go down and get filtered through.
We're going to be looking for a bit more from us this week and really sort of entertain the crowd. It's great going back to the Stoop. We haven't been there for a while, and obviously, you know, it's very close to our home at Twickenham. So it promises to be fantastic. You know, we know it'll be delivered really well, and we're really looking forward to going there. You know, it's great. It's a great ground, great place for rugby.
Set.
Squeeze.
Now what? Both parts. Squeeze. Now stay there. Both parts, stay there.
The rise is massive in terms of support, and you know, it's down to us to make sure we put a product on the field that's going to get people wanting to come and watch us again, and get people who haven't watched us to come and watch us for the first time, and that's what we're aiming to do.
So jam your foot into the wall, stretch it like that.
Okay, so we're going to be damn accurate in the breakdowns, but we scan active daps, and if we can see opportunities as backlines, we go pick them up.
It's the last game we're going to play together for a while. Let's make sure everything we do, our focus is we enjoy what we're doing and whatever element that is. So if that's physicality, if that's doing your job at set piece, whatever that is, let's make sure we do it.
This is the stuff that we want to deal with. This is the stuff we've got to get right. Can't play without a platform. That first one last yard that we've been talking about, the players have been going on and on about, okay, that we've got into our game. To make sure the last yard is the key yard for us. Hit with momentum. It couldn't be a better stage for us to go and play on today, so let's make sure we go and play. And when we walk off the field, okay, we know we've given it everything and we don't have that frustration we had last week. When we hit the breakdown, let's make sure we clear past the ball. Because if we can get a second quicker ball, it makes all the difference to our tempo. So stay with your thought processes. Keep doing the basics like we said. Right? Detail and execution. Go forward tempo. Be patient. Really focus in when it comes to set piece time. Really focus in when we're playing under pressure.
crowd. It was crazy. You know, this is the first time we come to the Stoop and played, and there's been three full stands. So, yeah, it was absolutely fantastic to get a record crowd here watching us. And it was a really physical and hard game, and, you know, we're glad to get 10 tries out there and pleased with aspects of our performance. Yeah, the Stoop was like my first cap. I also play at Quinn's now, so it's our home ground. I played for the Air Force here as well against the Navy, so I played quite a few times at the Stoop. It's always a place I like to come back to. 50 caps is amazing. You know, any cap for England is huge, so yeah, definitely proud of myself. We'll head back into our clubs, and it will just be back into club season as if it was a week shorter, so it's a very shame. I don't know when we'll play in the Italy game, but hopefully we'll get to play it.